Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about the status of women in India. The status of women in India has been subject to many changes over the span of recorded Indian history. Their position in society deteriorated early in India's ancient period, especially in the Indo-Aryan speaking regions, and their subordination continued to be refined well in India's early modern period. Practices such as female infanticide, dowry, child marriage, and the widow marriage, which began the upper caste of Hindu society in northern India, have long duration, providing difficult to root out. And instances of dowry have spread all caste classes and even religion. Several women have served various senior officials positions in Indian government, including the President of India, the Prime Minister of India, and Speaker of the Lok Sabha. However, many women in India continue to face significant difficulties. Now, we are going to learn about the status of women in India. Status of women in India. During British Raj, many socio-religious reforms like Rajaram Mohan Roy, Dayananda Saraswati, Keshav Chandra Sen, Aishwarya Chandra Vidyasagar, Pandit Ramabai, Dr. Muthulakshmi Ammayar, Jyothirao Phule Periyar, EVR, Dr. Dharmambal were the prominent leaders who fought for upliftment of women. Rajaram Mohan Roy's efforts led to the abolition of sati in 1829. Vidyasagar's crusade for the improvement in the conditions of widows led to the passing of Widow Remarriage Act of 1856. The reforms rightly realized that female education as an emancipating agent in eradication social evils. So they started girls' school in various parts of the country, which brought significant changes in the lives of women. Women played an important part in Indian freedom struggle. Until independence, there was no radical changes in the status of women. In independent India, last few decades have witnessed the all-round development of women. Women are now making their presence felt in every walk of life. The position of women in ancient period. Ancient period in ancient Indus civilization of India, evidences show that worship of mother goddess. Hence, the adoration for the mother is evident during that period. During Rig Vedic period, it is believed that the position of women was honored and women's position was acknowledged, especially in the performance of religious ceremonies. During later Vedic age, witnessed a transitional development in the status of women, restricting her role in the social life except in the performance of religious sacrifices. Her social and political freedom was restricted. Sati became popular during the later Vedic period, where the widows either chose for themselves or were forced to jump into pyre of their husbands. The patriarchal system became rigid. Women were denied to study the Vedic scriptures. Women, like other subordinate groups, remained silent in writing of history around the world for a long time. The invisibility women varied at over time, periods, and in social contexts. However, the Indian writings represent a situation of visibility of women in historical writings, especially in ancient Indian historiography. The zeal to understand women's position began during the time of colonization, when modern writings of ancient India were taking place. Both Western and Indian scholars undertook the study the status of women in ancient India, but with different perspectives. The nationalists and social reformers of 19th century often wrote against the backdrop of colonial rule and oppression. Such works provide a wealth of detail for situating women. The post-independence India witnessed more changes in the understanding of writing on women. The position of women in medieval period. The position of women in the society further deteriorated during the medieval period, and they suffered from many social evils such as sati, child marriages, female infanticide, and slavery. Normally, monogamy was the practice, but among the rich, polygamy was prevalent. Sati was in practice particularly among the royal and upper strata of the society. Widow remarriage was rare. Devadasi system was in practice in some part of India. Among the Rajputs of Rajasthan, the Jauhar was practiced. The condition of widow became miserable during the medieval period. But we don't ignore the fact that the Mughal ruler Akbar attempted to abolish sati. In fact, very little attention was paid to female education. Jauhar refers to practice of collective voluntary immolation by wives and daughters of defeated Rajput warriors in order to avoid capture and dishonor. Medieval period. During medieval times, women's education was not completely ignored, though no regular separate schools seem to have existed. Female education was informal. Girls usually had their lessons from their parents in their childhood. The rich appointed tutors to teach their daughters at home. The daughters of Rajput chiefs and zamindars studied literature and philosophy. Polygamy and parda system were practiced during the Muslim period. Women were restrained through the parda system, and movement outside the home was checked. The parda system affected their education. It also made women dependent on men for external work. Polygamy was in commonly practiced among their highest class Hindus. The Hindu widow spent her days in the most pathetic condition. The practice of child marriage resulted in different rapid increase in the number of child widows. The death of women was preferred to her falling into evil hands. The practice of sati was encouraged, and the widows who did not perform sati were looked down upon by the society. Thank you, students.